Good morning. Good morning to everyone. Welcome to online section. Dear student, I happy this moment. Today, you will learn about chemical reaction. Just a minute. I will share my PPT presentation to you. Okay, dear student, let us see. Today, topic name is chemical reactions. People, you should subscribe my YouTube channel and likes, comment and share it. Click the bell buttons. Let us start our class today. Today, motivation chart for Dr. Albert Einstein says that anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new. Keep your mind, dear student. I repeat, anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new. And today you will learn about one, reactants and products. Second, simple of chemical equations. Third, types of reactions. Fourth, what is a combination of reactions? And fifth, what is an exothermic reactions? Okay, you know that. You see the image of reactants and products. What is a reactants? Reactants is a starting material. And also, reactants are the substance that changes when it is combined with another chemical substance in chemical reactions. You will see the reactants X plus Y. It is reactants. The substance to the left of arrow in chemical equations are called reactants. And reactant is a substance that is present at the start of chemical reactions. Students, just note on that. I repeat a word. Reactant is a substance that is present at the start of chemical reaction. And next, product. The product is a new substance, and also it is a substance that result of chemical reactions. You will see the equations X plus Y, arrow mark, and XY. XY is a product. The substance to the right of arrow are called products. A product is the substance that is present at the end of chemical reaction. Next, we are going to discussing about that symbol of chemical equations, the symbols and meaning. Symbols plus arrow S. What is meaning by plus? Plus is it is used to separate one reactant or product from one another, and also it can be read as react with. Whenever chemical reaction written, if you have symbol of plus, it can be read as react with when used in reactant, and also it is read as and. It is read as and when it is used in product. And next, symbol of arrow, it is used to separate the reactant from the product, and also it is read as yield or products in an equation. You will see the image of reactant and product. I have equations X plus Y, arrow, XY. We should propagate X and Y react with or gives XY. And next symbol of S. What is meaning by S? It is indicates that a substance in a solid state. For an example, like a sodium chloride and a salt, it is a solid. Next, you will see image of L and G, AQ, its meaning aqua and delta. The first L, L is indicates that substance is in a liquid state like water and any chemicals. You can see that if in the chemical reactions we have written L. G, it indicates that substance is in gaseous state. For an example, hydrogen, helium, oxygen, carbon dioxide, it is a gaseous state, gaseous molecule. And next symbol, AQ, is aqua. It is represented by, it indicates that substance in dissolved in water. And next symbol, dear student, it's a very important. It is shaping like a triangle. It indicates there is a heat applied or need to make the reaction produced. I repeat, its symbols propagate, delta. It indicates that there is a heat applied or needed to make reaction produced. Okay, next one, we are going to discussing about types of reactions. There are five main types of reactions in chemical reactions. The first one, combination of reactions, decomposition of reaction. Third, single displacement reactions. Fourth, double displacement reaction. And fifth and last one for composition of reaction. Dear student, today you will learn about combination of reaction. You will see in this slide, combination of reactions, it is also known as synthesis reactions. So what is the combination of reaction? Reactions where two or more elements or components combined to form a single component, it is called a combination of reactions. It is a very important. Yes, student, I repeat, combination reactions where two or more elements or components combined to form a single component product, it is called as combination of reactions. For an example, x plus y, it gives xy. Combination of reactions can also occur in other situations when the two products do not have same ionic charge. In such a situation, different quantities of each reactant must be used. To denote this in a chemical equations, a coefficient is added to one or more of the reactants so that the total ionic charge of each reactant is the same. We'll see some example for you today. The first examples, combination of reactions, magnesium ribbon, it will get magnesium oxide powder. I will read equations, 2 mole of magnesium and 1 mole of oxygen, it gives 2 mole of magnesium oxide. Dear student, in the equations, I repeat once again, 2 mole of magnesium and 1 mole of oxygen and gives 2 mole of magnesium oxide. When magnesium metal burns, it react with oxygen found in air to form magnesium oxide, a compound is a material in which atom of different elements are bound to one another. Oxygen and magnesium combine in a chemical reaction to form this component. After it burns, it forms a white powder of magnesium oxide. You will see the equations. You will get magnesium plus oxygen, magnesium oxide powder. It is a white color. Let us see second example. In the combination of reactions, you know that, dear student, 2 mole of sodium and 1 mole of chlorine, and it gives 2 mole of sodium chloride. You will see, you know that sodium metal, it is a solid state, and chlorine, it is a gaseous state. And also you will see last product, it is a sodium chloride. I read once again. Chemical reactions, in the combination of reactions, your student, listen it carefully. 2 mole of sodium metal or sodium and 1 mole of chlorine, heat applied, just written for this heat or delta, it gives 2 mole of sodium chloride. If sodium metal and chlorine has mixed under the right conditions, they will form salt. Just note on that, if sodium metal and chlorine gas mix under the right conditions, they will form salt. The sodium loses an electron and the chlorine gains that electron. This reaction is highly favorable because of electrostatic attraction of between the particle. In this process, great amount of light and heat is released. It's very, very important. In this process, a great amount of light and heat is released. The resulting of salt is mostly unreactive, and also it is stable. It will not undergo any explosive reaction. So you will get the answer, product sodium chloride. And next one we are going to discussing about is an important exothermic process. What is a exothermic process? Exothermic process is the heat released along with the formation of product. And exothermic reaction is a chemical reaction that releases heat. It gives net energy to its surrounding. That is the energy needed to initiate the reactions is less than the energy released. Keep your mind, students, exothermic process, some amount of heat will be released, release of energy during the cellular respirations. Let us see some example for you today. You can see I have written for equations. 1 mole of glucose, 1 mole of oxygen, energy released, and it give products carbon dioxide and water. So you can see equation, chemical equations, glucose formula for C6H12O6. I repeat, carbon 6, hydrogen 12, oxygen 6. And you can see oxygen, 6 mole of oxygen, it gives 6 mole of carbon dioxide plus 6 mole of water plus energy, or energy released. Let us read the chemical equation for cellular respiration. The equation shows that 6 molecule of oxygen, 6O2, to break down 1 mole of glucose, C6H12O6, The arrow shows that when sugar is broken down, something else it is produced. It's like energy, water, and carbon dioxide are produced. When the chemical bonds of glucose molecules are broken, it is energy released. This kind of equation is called as exothermic reaction or exothermic process. Okay, dear student, I hope you will understand well. Thank you. Thank you, dear student. Peace be with you. Thank you.